Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2183, Load Data from a Corrupt Excel Workbook. If you're watching this video, I feel bad for you. I could be in the same boat right now. This repaired file is not repaired at all. This file, I've been working on this file all weekend, and I can open it. I can see the data, but the thing is corrupt. You see, I have two sheets, no formulas here, just data, tons and tons of data, data out to column L down to row 214, lots of work, and anytime I try to do anything with this, the file crashes. In fact, even if I just try and select the data to copy it, to take it somewhere new, Control-C, Microsoft Excel has stopped working. This thing is just lost. All right, here's my approach when I have a corrupt workbook. The very first thing I try and do, especially if I'm working in Excel 2013, is take that workbook to the computer that has Excel 2016 and open it there. 9 times out of 10, that solves the problem. Excel 2016 can deal with corrupt data better than Excel 2013 can. Although in this case, I'm already in Excel 2016, in the latest version of Excel 2016, so that's not going to help. Try to copy and paste to a new workbook. As you just saw, that's not going to work. Step 3, Power Query. We're going to cover that in this video. And then step 4, if all else fails, go out to Stellar Phoenix Excel Repair. There's a link down in the description down there. And it's $39 to buy their software that will try and recover the data. But today, we don't have to do that because I want to be able to solve this with Power Query. Control N for a new workbook. I'm in Excel 2016. This only works in Windows. If you're on a Mac, I'm so sorry for you. If you're in Excel 2010 or Excel 2013, you're going to download Power Query for free from Microsoft. All right, so here's what we're going to do. Excel 2016 data tab. I'm going to get data. This is in the get and transform data. Get data from a file, from a workbook. I find the file, click import. And they show me the two lists. The first worksheet I had was video list, and then the second worksheet was recap work. So I'm going to choose video list. They show me my data. I'm just going to simply click load. All right, beautiful. Comes in a table. I really don't want it as a table, but that's easy enough. Select all this data, Control C. Actually, they got too many columns there. Control C. Go to a brand new workbook, Control N. And then paste special values. That was Alt ESV. There's many different ways to do that. Use your favorite. And all we have to do is change the column widths. And then here, this date has to be a short date. And then here, this is also a short date. Press F4. All right, so now I'm going to save this file. Save as recovered. YouTube to article list. All right, we got the first half back. Now, let's see. Let's do Control N again. Data, get data from a file, from a workbook. We'll go back to the exact same workbook, the corrupt workbook. This time I want to go to the other worksheet, the recap worksheet. And again, just click load. My data comes back. Select the data, Control C, and I guess I can come here to my recovered file, insert a new worksheet, Alt ESV to paste special values, and that data is back. Now, you're going to lose formulas, you're going to lose links, but for me, right now, today, all I wanted was the data back. There were no formulas in there. I just didn't want to have to recreate this data that I spent all weekend working on. That worked for me, all right? Most of the time, just opening Excel 2016 solves it. Try to copy and paste to a new book. That didn't work. Power Query today solved it. If none of those work, then yep, $39, Stellar Phoenix Excel Repair. We'll be able to recover that data from your workbook. Check the link down there in the YouTube description. Episode recap. If you have a corrupt Excel file, the best thing to do is try and get to a newer version of Excel. Open the workbook there. See if you can save it. Removes the corruption. If that's not going to work, see if you can copy the data from Excel, paste to a new workbook, make sure to save that new workbook before you come back and close the old one. Lots of times, it's when you close that the file will crash. Third method from this episode, using the data tab, look for get and transform data and then get data. That uses Power Query. If you're in 10 or 13, you can download Power Query for free from Microsoft. If you're on a Mac, sorry, no Power Query. And then step number four, if nothing else works, the Stellar Phoenix software here, this URL down in the YouTube description, about $39 usually we'll be able to get at least most of your data back. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. Good luck with your file. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.